Hey y'all, Tom, ND3N here, and thanks for taking time to visit for another Ham Shack Chat. In this video, we're going to be comparing four similar rigs that I have in my shack. Let me start by stating that any one of these would be an affordable, full-featured, and quality radio for anybody's shack. I count myself extremely fortunate that I have all four to work with at any given time, plus my TS-890, but we're not going to cover that one. Of course, while all of these are great radios, they all have nuances that make them unique, while remaining so similar as to be functionally nearly identical. As always, corrections, questions, and general remarks may be left in the comments below.
Questions? Comments?
Now, let's see how these rigs stack up. And here's the stack. The order of this stack doesn't indicate any preference, personal, amongst the radios. I simply put the largest rig on the bottom and the smallest rig on top. As a top-level overview of each rig, starting at the top with the Yaesu FT991A, this is an all-mode HF plus 50 MHz and VHF UHF bands with C4FM, that's Yaesu System Fusion, on the 2 m and 70 cm bands. It uses heterodyning mixers for providing three separate IF frequencies and has DSPs, that's digital signal processing, on the HF and 50 MHz band audio signals. It has a 3.5-inch, that's measured diagonally, touch panel display. The FT991A has a manufacturer suggested retail price of $1,299.95, but you can usually pick it up at a lower cost. As of the date of this recording, Ham Radio Outlet has it with a price of $1,149.95, and DX Engineering has it for a price of $1,199.95. These reductions include store discounts, manufacturer specials, and rebates. In my operations, this rig will be becoming the heart of my Go Box and will be used for field day, parks on the air, and other portable type operations. Next down the stack is the ICOM IC7300 direct sampling rig. That means that the signal comes from the antenna and is converted from analog to digital, then processes through a field programmable gate array or FPGA. It also has digital signal processing circuitry. That way you can tweak your audio frequencies to make yourself sound best. It has a 4.3-inch, that's measured diagonally, touchscreen with multiple displays available to optimize your operating activity. This rig has an MSRP of $1,399.95, but can be purchased at a lower cost once store discounts, special manufacturing offers, and rebates are calculated in. As of the recording of this video, HRO's current price is $1,099.95, and DX Engineering's price is $999.95. Currently, and this changes with my mood and whims, this rig is my primary station digital rig. So, WSJTX, FT8, FT4, JS8 call, VARAC, Winlink, and so on, all happen using this rig, at least for now. If you're enjoying this so far, please take a moment to pop that thumbs up icon and give me a like.
I like that.
The Yaesu FT710 comes in two flavors. The AESS version includes the SP40 speaker. If you were to buy the speaker by itself, the HRO price is $119.95. The difference in the MSRP between the AESS and the field version without the speaker is $100. So, if you're going to get the speaker anyways, you can save yourself $20 by going with the AESS model. The MSRP for the field version, that's without the speaker, is $1,199.95. With both Ham Radio Outlet and DX Engineering selling them, as of the date of this recording, for $899.95, of course, after store discounts and manufacturing offers and rebates. The AESS, which by the way stands for Acoustic Enhancement Speaker System, has an MSRP of $1,200 and is being sold as of the date of this recording for $999.95 at both HRO and DX Engineering. The FT710 is a direct sampling software-defined radio using an FPGA and has a true digital signal processing at the audio level. It has a 4.3-inch screen that's measured diagonally, and it is a touchscreen with multiple displays available for your operating enjoyment. Since receiving this rig, I've been using it for voice work and have made several Parks on the Air and DX contacts, all with very good signal reports. The final rig we're going to look at is Yaesu's FT-DX10. It is a hybrid heterodyne and direct sampling software-defined radio SDR rig with true DSP. It has an MSRP of $1,699.95 and at the date of this recording is available from Ham Radio Outlet for $1,199.95 and at DX Engineering for $1,329. The unique hybrid nature of this rig allows for the best of both worlds. Even with my old ears, I can hear the difference in the noise level and quality of this signal between this and all the other rigs. The closest in quality is the FT710, but the 991A and the 7300 are no slouches either. This rig is my general purpose rig. Whether working CW, voice, or digital modes, this rig is more than up to the job. If this video has been of value to you, or if you're just enjoying the presentation, please share.
Why didn't you tell the world, eh?
It with your friends, compatriots, and cohorts in the amateur radio community, especially on social media. Now let's take a look at the similarities and differences of all the rigs all together. On all of the front panels, you'll see a fairly common layout with large tuning dials, audio volume, RF gain knobs, and most of the buttons that you'll need to operate. Not immediately noticeable is that the outer ring of the DX10 is actually a multi-purpose knob that is customizable to the majority of functions the radio has. That's for quick access. The size difference of the displays is noticeable from the small 3.5 up to the 5-inch display of the DX10. Regardless of the size, the information presented is well laid out and easy to interpret, so it helps your operations. All of the rigs, with the exception of the 991A, have SD card slots for recording setup and on-the-air activities and doing things like firmware updates and just stuff like that. Now, we're going to spin this around, take a look at the back of the rig. All of the rigs have identical Molex 4-pin power input, which makes it real useful when you're moving things around. You don't have to move the power supplies. All of the rigs have HF and 50 megahertz ports, and the FT991A adds a UHF VHF port. All of the rigs have a USB B-type or printer cable connector, and that's here, 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 and there. All of the rigs have a keyer jack for CW mode. One of the most important things, all of the rigs have very good and efficient cooling fans. Also, on all of the rigs, you can find external speaker jacks. The differences, All of the Yaesu radios have access for a remote control, which is this little device right here. And this is the FH2 remote control. Although I can use it on any of the rigs, and I have used it on all of the rigs, I keep it plugged into the DX10 for most of the time. The FT991A and the DX10 both have RS-232 ports available for additional CAT control. The IC7300 has a CIV port, which is also used for CAT control. The FT710 has a USB Type A input here, and this is for running a mouse or a keyboard. And down here, the DX10 has two of these ports for running a mouse and a keyboard. I've tried running one of those sets where you have a single wireless access for a mouse and a keyboard. That didn't work for me. Both of them have mice attached, and that is really a nice feature. Finally, the FT710 and the DX10 both have DVI-D external display outputs. Quite honestly, I have a bone to pick with the design engineers for this radio on this feature. DVI is an older technology that has long been surpassed by others, such as HDMI. Well, 10 years ago, just about every monitor had a DVI input. These days, they're few and far between. Now, how hard would it have been to make this connection HDMI?
Do you know how hard that is to do?
And to reflect back to the beginning, that's the stack. I hope you've enjoyed viewing this as much as I've enjoyed putting it all together for you. Please remember to like, share, and comment. Also, please consider subscribing to this channel. 73, until the next Hey Y'all, as always, I am at your service. This has been a Ham Shack Chat. I'm Tom, ND3N, and I am out.
What'll they think of next?